This is how you can use an external hard drive to watch your movie collection on a Roku Ultra. In my last video, I showed you how to digitize your DVD movie collection. If you missed that one, follow the suggested video here or click on the link in the description of this video. Now I'm going to show you how you can watch that library of movies on your TV using the Roku Ultra. The Roku Ultra provides a USB port for an external hard drive or flash drive. I use a Seagate 2TB external hard drive with a USB 2.0 extension cable. I've confirmed with Roku support that the USB port on the Roku is limited to 2TB. I've even confirmed that you can't use a larger hard drive and partition it into smaller volumes. 2TB is the limit for any connected storage. I also use a 2.0 extension cable to force the hard drive to 2.0 speeds. This avoids the need for a USB-powered hub since the Roku USB port is underpowered for a USB 3.0 hard drive. While the Roku Ultra USB is a bit lacking, you can overcome these challenges with this inexpensive solution. With the storage attached and movie files installed, you can fire up your Roku Ultra and load the Roku Media Player. You'll have access to video, audio, or photos stored on your external hard drive. Select one and open your attached USB drive. All your movies are listed. You can divide them into folders or simply choose one from an alphabetical list. Select one from the list and play your movie. It's that simple. You're really only limited by the storage capacity of your external device. Another nice feature is that you can push the asterisk on the remote to search for a movie. Enter a file name and select the movie from the search results. The Roku Ultra is a brilliant solution to store and watch hundreds of movies from your movie library. In my last video, I showed how you can convert your DVD disc to MKV files using a free program called MakeMKV. One important tip I want to share is that larger Blu-ray files may not play correctly on the Roku, and the solution is to compress the MKV file to an MP4 or M4V file using Handbrake. Handbrake is another free program you can download from handbrake.fr. Once you load Handbrake, you're going to want to go into the Tools Preferences, and under Output Files, go ahead and set your default folder path where you want the converted files to be stored. I prefer to set the file format to just source so it comes out with the same file as the original. And you're going to want to choose between MP4 or M4V. I prefer to leave this automatic, which actually does M4V files. Those work fine in the Roku. Go back. You're going to open the source location that you want to convert. You can choose a folder if you want to do an entire batch, or you can do just a single file. Let's pick a file and hit open. Now, the couple of settings that you're going to want to look at is under video, set this frame rate to the same as source. And then under presets, select devices and choose the Roku. And you can choose between a full 4K or 1080p, whatever you want for your quality. Once that's set, start encoding. And as you can see, it takes a few minutes to run this, but we'll go ahead and skip ahead. It's taken that original file of 4 GB and dropped it down to less than 1. With this kind of compression ratio, you're able to get 4, 5 or more times as many videos onto a 2TB hard drive, and they play at virtually the same quality as the original. So I've chosen to do this compression on my entire video collection. That gives you a quick summary of how to watch your DVD movie collection using the Roku Ultra with an external hard drive. Check out the description of this video for links to the components I used to make this work, and be sure to watch my last video on how to digitize your DVD movie collection to get started. Hey, if you want to see more videos like this one, please subscribe, and if you've enjoyed this video, be sure to click the thumbs up and leave a comment. I really do appreciate your support.